Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming tonight. We didn't get too wet when you're coming here. This is our faculty group, and they started about less than 10 rehearsals ago. So there's some here that have no musical experience at all, but you will be able to pick them out because they're pretty good. Now, they're nervous, but I told them, you're one of the two best steel drum bands at Bethel College. So, you know, you got nothing to worry about. This first song is Just Now, and the reason I called it that is the people who make these drums are the Trini, the people from Trinidad, and I met one who was tuning my drum, and he left for a while, and I said, when are you going to come back? And he said, I'm coming back just now. I thought, that's not real English, but what do you mean by that? And I asked my partner, and he said, hey, it doesn't matter. It's none of your business. So that's what this song is. It doesn't really mean that, but I thought that was kind of funny. Just Now.
Thank you.
By a show of hands, how many people knew that song? So, was that a Willie Nelson song? You sing that, Willie Nelson? On the Road Again, Willie Nelson? Okay, just checking. It's pretty blank. This next song, I have to do a couple of thank yous. I want to thank Shirley and Donna Lynn for doing our programs for us tonight. Shirley and Donna Lynn. And just for all these guys coming and having fun, it's a different, they come from all different places from the campus, and it's just kind of fun to get to know them a little bit. It's my first year here, so it's fun to get to know them a little bit and just play music with them. This next song, I'm sure there's not very many people that don't know. Should have brought the expensive one. Sorry. Okay. Lion Sleeps Tonight. I had to write some notes on this one. The guy that that made this famous actually got it wrong. It was not originally called that. It's a Zulu song from the 30s, and it's actually supposed to be Uwemboiwa. Oh, sorry, Uwemboiwa. As close as I get it. But he heard Uwemboiwa, which it really, the Uwemboiwa means you're a lion. The Uwemboiwa means, I roughly translated, please evacuate the tree. So, not the same ring to it, but I, you know, it's edutainment. I want to make sure you come away with a good edutainment. So, like, this is A Lion Sleeps Tonight. Thank you. Well, this group has a variety of people in it, meaning we have some people who have just joined the group this semester. I won't point them out because I don't want to make any pressure on them, but we have people who have played for years. We have people who have just started, which you couldn't really tell, could you, because they're so talented. But this art form started in Trinidad about 1938-39, and Ellie Bennett and Winston Spree Simon are the two people that the names are associated. The guy that actually made a couple of my drums is Ellie Bennett, and he made those basses back there. So those basses are like our works of art, and they're considered like Picasso. They're about worth $4,000. So that's about what, $700 a drum? Bad at math, but they're expensive. So these drums cost a lot of money, and like these drums over here, or these guitars, were probably $1,000. So over time, I just started. Time and the internet helped me out a little bit. I used to sell these drums, and so I started accumulating them. Judy has her own drums, and she's been playing since 1995. She was one of my first students when I taught at Nickerson High School back in, well, Worms were young, Dirk was young, and she used to be a lead player, and now she's on double seconds. And tragically, she's going to stop playing now because she's going to sell her drums. So this is her last match. I just want to say thank you for all the time and energy for us. So thank you for helping us. So when he traveled to go get his wife, when he got to that place where the crash had happened, the captain came and said, this is where it was, and he pinned the words to this. So when I was arranging this, I was thinking about, you'll hear a couple of things that I want you to think about. One is that the guitars and the double seconds, when we get into the second time through, have kind of a rolling river type or ocean type of sound. So I want you to think about that. And near the end, where it talks about the trumpet resounding, the leads kind of have a trumpet-like figure, so you'll hear that. And I wrote this in tribute to my wife, who died 3 years ago. So it was our favorite hymn. And I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
that people ask us a lot, I don't know about them, but they ask me a whole lot, is, are these really hard to play? And I would say, I would compare it to a typewriter. Remember when you first started typing, you'd only do one or small words like and. It's the same thing here. You play a few things, and then you keep adding to it. But it's more about repetition. Because you notice that they don't look down at their drum slot. They better not be, are they? That girl is okay. After a while, you just know where they're at. You don't have to look down, just like typing. People who type well, I should say, don't look down. Some of us who just use two fingers still have to do that. But that's one thing. And the other thing that people say or ask, do these drums ever go out of tune? Yes, they go out of tune. If we were playing in direct sunlight in the heat, they would go out of tune temporarily until you brought them back in out of the sun or poured water in them. And the other thing that could happen to them is if they fell over or they were dropped or something like that, which never happened. Well, it happens a little bit, actually. And that's a bad thing, because when they go out of tune, then we have to have them tuned. And you don't just, it's not like you have a piano tuner coming. You have to have somebody who's a steel drum tuner. And we don't have any of those in Kansas or Oklahoma or anywhere around here. We do have one in Texas, in Austin, so that's pretty close. So when we do have to have them tuned, if they're small enough, it's just a small drum, I might drive it down there. My sister-in-law happens to live there, so that's a good thing. But if it's a big drum, like a bass or something, if there's a steel drum tuner coming through Kansas, sometimes I'll have them stop and say, last year, 2 years ago at Haven High School, we had them tuned, all of them. In fact, this isn't all the drums. Did I already say that? This isn't all the drums. Next year, this group will be 7 or 8 people larger. So we've already got that filled to next year. So, and if we have to have more drums and more bands, that's okay with me. So, let's see. Tobago Jam. Now, I wanted to talk to you about the drumming for a little bit. And you notice that the first four songs had four different styles of drumming. The first one, Banana Funk, was a rock funk beat. And then One Love was, of course, reggae. And then as well has kind of a march. Spin Cycle was kind of a rock song. This next song is Tobago Jam. And it has a soca beat. Soca stands for soul and calypso. Soul and calypso, soca. Julian, can you play that soca beat for me? Well, that's all. Okay, he's on the clock. So, 2 majors, that's it. No, he's a fantastic drummer, but this is his first time playing that this kind of music. Am I right on that? The soca beat, this is the first year for that? And he's actually a staff member here, so. I had learned that soca beat. I am a percussion major, and I didn't know that beat until I got into a steel drum band. So I just wanted you to know that's the beat we're doing here, and this is Tobago Jam. I was debating whether or not to take an offering tonight. I know that's decided not to. But then I got a call the other day, and I got a call from a gentleman, or an anonymous person, but they were unanimous about this. They said that anything that you, if people would like to give at your concert, I will match it dollar for dollar. Because one thing that we would use that money for is to tune drums, buy more mallets and stands and things like that. So if you're wanting to do that, we'd invite you. There's those steel drum cases over there on each side. And if you do, I didn't want to pass up those big things, like an offering tray. So if you'd like to put some money in there, that's totally up to you. If you want to write a check, it's to Bethel College, and we'll make sure it's tax deductible. So let's see. The tide is high. Now, there's been some discussion about this song. Now, I knew this song, Tide is High, when Blondie did it in 1976. But they said, no, it's Lizzie McGuire. And I'm like, who's Lizzie McGuire? So, I remember my daughter used to watch Lizzie McGuire. So, this is The Tide is High. It's one of those rubber balls that you squeeze for stress, only it's cut in half, and then they have an aluminum shaft here, and they have kind of a rubber handle. Well, when I started, we had actually just a pink rubber ball on a stick. That's all we had. And it was in Phoenix, and we were playing by the pool, and of course the glue got kind of, flimsy. So I'm playing along, and you remember what she looked like back there. Imagine me doing that. about the same velocity, and all of a sudden, I'm playing along, and out of the corner of my eye, I saw that pink rubber ball fly off the end of that stick. And I had to keep playing, because we, you know, we're getting paid, so I'm playing along with one hand, and trying not to hit this one, because this one sounds bad when you hit it, because there's no ball on it. And actually, there's a lady in the pool watching us, sitting on the, just watching us on the side, you know, and I hit her square in the head. After she came to, she was very gracious. They revived her. I've never seen CPR. Anyway, we still actually, it's 30 years later now, and we still keep in contact. Her lawyer and I, through her lawyer, we still. There you go. Well, I bet you didn't think that you got up this morning and thought, I wonder if I'm going to hear Elvis Presley on the steel drum today. But I'd neglect to put it in the program, I think. And this is Can't Help Falling in Love with You. It's a love from Elvis, the King.
Thank you.
Just think how good it'll be next year. Just think about it. Again, if you want to see the drums more up close, I'd invite you to do that. And if you want to make a donation, that would be great too. Otherwise, have a good evening.